put my arm around him. Didn't know what else to do.
So what did he do?
He threatened to throw her out and close down the office. He dared to stand up to her. I think that's why he was killed.
Well, now look, Margaret. You told me some reasons why maybe your stepmother might have a motive.
But they're all true.
I didn't say they weren't. But you don't have any proof of them. And you don't have any evidence. All you have is your assumptions. You understand? Besides, how could she do it? What would she do? Involve some other people? That would be very risky, wouldn't it? No, you see, the only possible way would be... No. No, that's crazy.
What is it?
No, it just occurred to me that the only possible way would be if somehow there never was a kidnap.
She killed him, then set it up to look that way.
Well, no, I never said that. I mean, that's a crazy idea. I mean, forget that.
Lieutenant, how do you go about proving something like that?
Oh, goodness, I don't know how to do that. Listen, I think you got a crazy idea there. I think you ought to forget about it.
Well, I'll be in touch with you, Lieutenant.
All right. All right. Might be something in the position of the car seat.
Did you say something?
I said there might be something in the position of the car seat.
What car seat?
Your father's car. You know, the night they picked up your father's car, somebody noticed that the car seat had been moved forward.
I don't understand.
Your father's a very tall man, isn't he? I mean, he's 6 foot or better. Well, whoever drove that car last, they had moved the seat forward.
Like a woman?
Could be. And of course, there's your father's keys.
What about them?
We never found them. Keys weren't in the car. And later on, when we found your father's body, the keys weren't on the body either.
So?
But did you ever notice how, just out of habit, when you get out of a car, you automatically reach for the keys? You see, the last person out of that car instinctively took the keys with him.
And may still have them.